Augmented reality is laying digital content in the physical world, delivered on different devices like phone and head-mounted devices and so on. The devices used in AR can sense you. They can sense what you're touching. They can sense your hands. They can see the objects you're manipulating. So therefore, unlike videos, AR can actually come in and help you. AR can understand what you do and learn from your demonstration. You can appear in somebody else's place and help them, but you don't have to be there. So that's why there's so much of excitement about AR. We created this platform called MetaAR. We made creation of AR content as simple as creating a PDF file. Our software takes care of creating all the code for what you're doing. We created a project where the students create a smart city with lighting and so on, kind of like a circuit board. We call it spatial user interfaces, meaning that the interface is not anymore a mouse and a keyboard. It's your hands and your eyes, and it's the real world, right? Because it's seeing your hands, it knows what you're doing, it can adjust to you. If you haven't finished that task, it's going to wait for you to finish it. If you don't do it correctly, it's going to potentially tell you like what to do correctly. The coach now can be watching on his screen all the 40 people. I don't have to go and peek at everybody behind the shoulder to see what they're doing. Now I can incorporate feedback from students right away and improve the lab. Students were easily able to absorb these ideas of collaboration in real time and asking for help. It seemed like it was what they were born with. We started figuring out how to make our software better because we were getting very good feedback from the students as to what works, what doesn't work. We can replicate ourselves or capture our knowledge of doing things in the physical world and deliver it to somebody else. We can create such AR applications for very, very different contexts, whether it's fixing stuff at your home, or it's building a circuit, or it's doing some assembly, or working in a factory-like setting, operating controls, and so on and so forth. For the high end, it can be robotic surgery and training doctors and nurses. I don't have to have it in the classroom. The classroom can go to your home. In our demonstration, we have made that real. We want to scale the human. We want to extend the teacher's capability of reach. And we want to make hands-on education be hands-on.